to neutral side action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Bulldogs' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They'll bring him down at the 50.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Good outside run there.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Around the 29-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
Right back to the run game, and this time he's met immediately.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
He's knocked out of bounds at the 23. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Tackled at the 17.
I think he just barely got it. That's a great job by both the quarterback and receiver to keep this drive alive.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. And he is drilled at the 21. From the 21-yard line, it's second down. He's taken down at the 7-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Zips it to the tight end, and he's taken down at about the 3-yard line. They're at the 3. Second down. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. This is the 12th play of this drive. On a counter, wrestled down behind the line. Fourth down, they'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Georgia could take the lead with this field goal.
Kicks away.
And it is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. From his own goal line. Brought down at the 27-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. And he's tackled right around the 28-yard line. From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Lost the ball, fumble, and they fall on the loose ball. They nearly gave that ball away.
But luckily, that guy was paying attention to what was going on and was able to recover the football.
Complete. He's got room. The 50. And they make the stop around the 45-yard line.
I'd go right back to him. He's got the skills to make things happen, and the defense might not be able to keep up at this moment.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. Quick, he catches another, and down he goes at about the 41. That brings him second and five. Quick throw, incomplete, blocked his receiver. Third down again. That'll make it third and five. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's at the 30. He gets hit out of bounds around the 27-yard line.
That's just a well-executed screen pass. They had the blockers in front, and they got it to him with room to run.
He's got it with room to run. Tackle made at the 14. From the 14-yard line, it's first down. After a quarter of play, we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. The Bulldogs lead 3-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Dives for extra yardage. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 3-yard line. Down just outside the goal line. This is the 11th play of this drive. Touchdown, Canes. He adds the extra point. It was an 11-play, 72-yard drive, and it It's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. They'll spread the field with five wide. And they push him out at about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line. Second down. And tackled in the backfield.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, you're probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
He airs it out. Found his man. To the 20, to the 10, touchdown, Georgia!
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
Boy, that was an easy throw for the quarterback. Had to be a mistake of some kind or miscommunication by the defense in that secondary, but the quarterback finds his receiver wide open for the touchdown.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he converts the extra point. A short three-play, 75-yard drive, and a touchdown's a result.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boy, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. He gets to about the 41-yard line. Their own 41-yard line. First down. Caught with room to work. They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. Play action. Now he's on the move. He's at the 30. Dives forward.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
From the 19-yard line, first down. Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Third and 10 coming up. Ball on the 19. Strike to his receiver. No good.
Good effort there by the receiver, but just not enough room for him to get a foot down in bounds.
Well, I think he came down with it, but from up in the booth, it's hard to tell. So the official's taking a look at this play to see if the receiver got a foot in bounds.
Regardless of the outcome of this review, I still think that this guy made an excellent catch.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after review, they decide that this call should be reversed. Here's the eighth play of the series. Once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
When they need a play, you usually know who's going to get the ball. Excellent run to put these guys up on top.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. Knocked out of bounds, right around the 16-yard line.
Georgia's gotten the play out of their quarterback, and you expect that that was going to happen, but, I mean, what is happening here? Somebody else is going to have to come to the forefront, or this thing's going to be over.
If you would have told me before the game that this quarterback would have played like this through the first quarter and a half or so, I would have thought this team would have been leading this game. And you're right. Something has got to happen where his teammates, the rest of this group, they've got to raise their game if they want to have any chance of winning this game.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 35. At the 45. What a throw for a big gain.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Gets it out quickly to the back, but he can't haul it in. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. He's immediately tackled. Makes it to the 41.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
He gets rid of this one. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 41. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he hits him hard at the 14-yard line. Throws to the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 14. Just gets rid of it. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Quick release, tight end, incomplete. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. It's up, and it's through the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Miami is up one. Now he's scrambling. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line.
The Hurricanes will use their first time out of the half. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. The D sniffs out the screen pass and holds him to a short gain.
Contain, contain, contain. That's the only way you can shut down a guy with 4-2 speed.
Under pressure, he chucks it downfield. This one will fall incomplete. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. Got him. They tried to throw for it, but ended up getting sacked. We've played a half of football here. The Hurricanes lead it by one.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two gangs match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin, and we got a tight game here.
Excellent kick. He's to the 20, and down he goes at the 23-yard line.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again.
Miami up a point. Catches it, and that's all. A 7-yard gain that time from the play-action pass completion.
The defense wasn't fooled too much by the play-action, but it gave the quarterback just enough of a cushion to find his receiver.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
He's scrambling. He's to the 40, diving for extra yardage.
It out to his receiver in a hurry, and they make the stop at the 49. The pass good for maybe 7 yards.
Hey, they picked up a nice gain of 7 yards on that play. Great pass.
It's second down, 3 to go. Ball on the 49.
There he goes.
Tackle made around the 43-yard line.
Gets out to about the 42-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
from the 42-yard line. Second down. Throws it in a hurry. He's tackled right around the 28-yard line. He's at the 20. And down he goes around the 11-yard line. Play of this drive. Miami with a one-point lead. Looks to the end zone. Fires a laser touchdown. The PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Nice run up the middle. Second and five. Ball on their own 30. Midfield inside the 30, and he shoved out of bounds at the 16. That makes it first and 10. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. The 10. Touchdown, Bulldogs. Here we go. They'll try to tie it up right here with a two-point conversion. Play 76-yard drive, and they get 6 points on the board after failing the two-point conversion.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, sir.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. Be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half.
Really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. Miami is up two. Down at the 42-yard line. Fires complete over the middle.
I think anchors a great play call. It was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down.
Where's 52? Watch 52. 52's the mic.
He makes it to the 48-yard line. Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 49-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Miami with a two-point advantage.
Here we go. Gray 95. Gray 95.
Going long. Got him again. Touchdown, Miami. Here's the extra point that'll make it a two-score game. And he converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense will come out again hoping to have similar results as their last drive.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
Quick strike, and he drops it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Bring him down at the 27.
That's a good gain of 2 yards. That'll bring up third and 8.
Caught out in the open. And he's tackled around the 34-yard line. They're just one quarter away. Miami's lead is 9. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From their own 49-yard line, first down. At the 30-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 30-yard line.
Ready.
He gets rid of this one. Here's the give.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
It's fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. Kicks up. And he got it.
Great snap and a perfect hold, and he just had an awesome follow-through. Everything went right there on that long field goal.
Our score after the field goal, Miami 28, Georgia 22. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. A score here might effectively end this one. Miami with a six-point lead. Gets out to around the 35. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. For his tight end over the middle, and he's taken down at the 42. From the 42-yard line, first down. Tries to buy some time. Room around the corner. Decides to slide. Georgia's going to take their first time out of the half. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Just over 2 minutes in the game. He's out of bounds at the 34. Pushed out of bounds at the 29.
I think the defense put everything into that sequence of plays, and for the offense to come up with a first down really is demoralizing for the defense.
Decent run here, right side. The Bulldogs using their third and final timeout, and this play is number 8 on the drive. Inside the 10. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
they've got their eyes on that goal line. He's taken down at the 5-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. And they make the stop around the 2-yard line. So this one's in the books, and we saw a great one here today. Miami 28, Georgia 22. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.